guys, what's up, Libra? Thanks for watching, appreciate it. We're gonna do a love reading for the month of February. We're gonna break it down week by week and look at two situations for each week so you can have a heads up of what's coming up. We'll also grab some, we'll see what the love energy is around you guys for the month of February. So remember that the energies can be reversed, so flip it how you need to. Also remember it's a general reading, so just take what's yours, leave the rest behind. If it does resonate, please make sure that you like and subscribe below. And if you'd like to contact me for a personal reading, that is below as well. All right, Libra for February, starting with the Strength card and the Page of Wands. You got the Star. Oh, could be a superstar, or somebody here makes you very happy. It's a really nice energy for some. Well, we got that Five of Cups, and then we have like all this, like, happy ass moving forward. There could be like somebody coming over, traveling, moving in. But then there is, with the overall energy being the Six of Pentacles and the Page of Swords, there may be somebody that by the end of the month like feels guilty for their decisions. And the reason I say that is just purely based off of, or it's almost like a grass wasn't greener. By the time, we'll clarify and see what's going on when we get down there. But it's like the energy of the first week kind of needing some willpower, or, you know, kind of determination to go towards something that somebody's wanting. Then it looks like it really works out and there's a lot of happiness. But then around the third week, we get this Four of Pentacles. So I don't know if somebody is holding on to something, and then it kind of brings this grass wasn't greener, shoulda, woulda, coulda. We're going to find out. Because all of these are so, like, for some, there could be even, like, somebody's dream house that's here. The Ace of Cups just fell out. That is love and new love, if you're looking for the brand new. But it still feels by the end of the month like something is not all that, even after all this happy energy, it's still not completely happy. We're going to see. Maybe it's an apology that's there. But with this energy over here that's tugging, this Page of Swords and the Six of Pentacles, it's almost like somebody may have a choice to make. And I don't mean that has to be between people. It can be a choice between like even spending money or a home situation, commitment. At the bottom of the deck, you got the Empress, that's your energy, the Two of Swords, the Devil, and the World. So you've been working your ass off to make a lot of changes and to kind of set boundaries and limitations on situations and people, things like that, that weren't in your highest good, that weren't serving your highest good. Would you look at that? When we come down just a little bit more, there may be a cycle on repeat. We got the Page of Swords and the Six of Pentacles. It's the same card that's here for the overall energies. Okay, let's see what's going on. So what is the overall love energy around Libra, please, for February? Travel is definitely possible. I mean, even with this reading, you got not enough. Frustrated in relationship, lack of confidence, self-sabotage, fear and ego issues, and jealousy. You also have the Phoenix, new phase, rekindle, renew, transformation, growth, and change mind. So for some, I feel like this might be, definitely like a past person or a past situation. But then you have Girl with the Snake, empath and narcissist, being charmed or used, enable boundaries. And it looks like that happened in the past. All right. Let's start with the first week. We got the Strength card and we got the Page of Wands. So again, I am seeing this as two different situations, but in general, we got a whole lot of Leo energy, fire energy. So it looks like there's something here that somebody is interested in, excited about. Why is the Strength card there for Libra, please? For, oh, okay, there's an opportunity right off the bat. Could be an Aquarius, but you have the Star card the next week as well. So it does look like there's an opportunity at the beginning of the month. It does look like it's something that it could be an Aquarius, but also with the Star card, that is something that we're wishing for, that we're hoping for. And this Page of Wands is still here in the Four of Pentacles. It's very important to ensure that somebody's not holding on or holding back. Hold on. It's holding on to something. And the reason I say that is because over here, we do have an opportunity that's coming, right? Something that you're wishing for. These cards are like repeating themselves. The same week we got the Page of Wands. But a few weeks later, before we have this Five of Cups, like the grass wasn't greener, we also have somebody holding on to something. I mean, it can be like holding back financially, but it's kind of like seeming like a cycle here. Well, show me the Page of Wands for the first week for Libra, please. The Devil. You have a definite, the Devil and the Two of Swords, Capricorn energy. You have to be careful what you wish for energy up there. And with the Devil being there, this, it does feel like something that somebody is, it's almost like not even paying attention to, because on one side there's an opportunity and then over here we got the Devil, and we keep talking about somebody holding on to something and like the grass wasn't greener, shoulda, woulda, coulda by the end of the month. So it's kind of like acknowledging especially your intuition because of some of these oracle cards. It can go a couple of ways, but show me that second week for Libra, please. So the second week, you got the Star and the Six of Wands. I mean, somebody could be seen like a freaking rock star front and center. What's going on the second week around love? You got the King of Pentacles and the Three of Wands. You could be dealing with an earth sign. Also, somebody could be at a distance. There is like a waiting energy. Or like a distance that's there. Somebody's really worried that they're missing an opportunity, or that like they've missed their chance, but they're not necessarily saying it. This could be somebody, it can go a couple of ways, who's very like, very about their money, or it can even be somewhat like materialistic, or somebody who's very held on to something. It's hard for this energy to let go of certain aspects. And that can be around career, things like that. Show me the Six of Wands, please, for the second week for Libra as well. You got the Knight of Wands. That's fire energy. But tell me more about that, because there definitely could be like raises, promotions here. But you got the Six of Pentacles. This is somebody who can be kind of in and out, back and forth. It feels like things kind of take off quickly. But you see with this Knight of Wands here, a very busy energy, but this can be also a non-committal in and out. It does look like, again, somebody's money could really be coming up. But remember the week before we had this Devil and the Two of Swords, and I said it was like something that's kind of not being acknowledged, not being brought up. So the next week you have the Six of Pentacles, and you can see again with these energies that like there's an energy in the middle and then there's two energies on the side. There's something that's kind of blocking things. Not that things don't seem great some of the times, but also it's kind of like accepting the reality. Show me the Chariot for the third week. The Chariot is Cancer energy. You got the Three of Swords. You have the Three of Wands right above this the first week as well. the Queen of Swords, that's your energy. You're moving forward in this energy of protecting your heart. You could be creating some type of distance that's here, but could be very focused into work as well. But as far as love, you've got some, there could be pain on someone's part, but it is also about protective of heart type of energy. Because this exact same week, we have the energy I've been talking about all the whole video, because we're kind of getting up to that, damn, the grass wasn't greener. And this week, we got the Four of Pentacles here. So even if you're not dealing with the earth sign, it can be this energy that, you know, like I said, it's very much held on to something there. Show me this Four of Pentacles, please, for Libra for the third week. The Six of Wands. Same card that was there the week before. And the Four of Pentacles. Same card that's there. Give me one. Thank you. The Hermit. Virgo energy and the Eight of Swords. You got the Four of Pentacles twice. This looks like somebody who is, I mean, it could be anything from a player to like somebody who's wanting the best of both worlds. So it kind of, it causes somebody to have divided attention. I mean, maybe somebody's just really busy with work. But by the end of the month, we have this serious grass wasn't greener. And here we have the Eight of Swords and the Hermit. And this is somebody, again, worried, wanting to hold on now. Hold on to the side that possibly, you know, the second week there may have been some distance that was created. Oh, shit. It's also not a time to overspend. Show me this Five of Cups, please, for the fourth week for Libra. Honestly, this looked better before I, clarified it. Oh, you got the Ten of Pentacles, the Chariot, which again was there the week before. Honestly, there could be some moving that happens this week. It looks like things try to gain a whole lot more stability. There's apologies there. Also, this is where kind of the grass wasn't greener comes in. The feelings are still here. They're acknowledged. This looks like this fourth week, a situation where it's kind of, there is regret there, there's guilt. And also it's a situation where it may feel like, you know, things have been kind of difficult or painful, but looking at the whole situation because the feelings are there. So at the same time, you have this apology energy and it is coming across as sincere, and possibly somebody, moving, it could even be coming over. So for some, I mean, this definitely could be somebody who is really into their money, career, finances, and trying, or it even can be like a gambling type energy. It can be a couple of things. With the Knight of Wands and the Six of Pentacles, we can also have a player type energy here. Somebody who is real protective about like their reputation, their ego. It doesn't have to go that far. This could just definitely be somebody who is really busy. But it feels like at the beginning, right away at the beginning with this opportunity that presents itself, there's something that has to be, it's not necessarily seen. But it's almost like it's sidestepped. It's not acknowledged. All right, Libra. I hope this helped. If it resonated, please make sure that you like and subscribe below. If you'd like to contact me for a personal reading, that is below as well. You guys take care, and I will see you next time. Bye.